Somewhere out there in the darkness of the cold universe is a carbonaceous asteroid shooting through space from the Apollo group that was discovered on September 11, 1999. It is a potentially hazardous object that is listed on the Sentry Risk Table with the second highest cumulative rating on the Palermo Technical Impact Hazard Scale, a logarithmic scale used by astronomers to rate the potential hazard of a near-Earth object. And it's getting closer to Earth every minute. Named after the ancient Egyptian mythological bird associated with the sun, creation and rebirth, the asteroid Bennu was heavily observed by scientists from the Arecibo Observatory and the Goldstone Deep Space Network as it came closest to the planet Earth on September 23, 1999. It is an ancient relic of our solar system's early days, dating back to more than 4.5 billion years. Scientists say that this space rock likely broke off from a much larger carbon-rich asteroid about 700 million to 2 billion years ago and formed in the main asteroid belt between Mars and Jupiter. However, the gravitational pull from Saturn dislodged it from the belt, and it has drifted much closer to the Earth since then. It is very possible that this one could end up eventually hitting the planet in the last quarter of the 22nd century. Bennu is roughly 1,640 feet in diameter, about the same height as the Empire State Building in New York. It orbits our sun every 1.2 years, and every 6 years it comes very close to Earth, within 0.002 astronomical units, or AU, which is about 185,911 miles away. That's very close, considering it's within the orbit of the Moon, which is on average 238,855 miles away from us. This rocky rubble pile asteroid weighs 68 million tons and has an average orbital speed of 63,000 miles per hour. Bennu has a 1 in 2,700 chance of hitting the Earth, but such an event wouldn't take place until 2175 or 2196. It won't be until the year 2135 that researchers will be able to get a better idea of its collision course with the planet. If Bennu enters a keyhole between the Earth and the Moon, it is possible its orbit could shift so that it would likely hit the Earth on a subsequent approach. But what would happen if Bennu did head towards the planet on a collision course? During atmospheric entry, Bennu would begin to break up at an altitude of 236,000 feet. The mass of the rock would hit the Earth at a velocity of over 27,000 miles per hour, and the impact would release energy equivalent to 1,450 megatons of TNT. To put that in some perspective, the fission bombs used in World War II had an energy release of roughly 20 kilotons of TNT. And the most powerful nuclear weapon ever detonated, the Russian Tsar Bomba, had a yield of 50 megatons. In fact, if you total up the total energy expended during all the nuclear testing in history, you're looking at 510 megatons of TNT. With that in mind, Bennu would release three times more energy than all the nuclear weapons detonated throughout history. However, the effect of impact on Earth would be insignificant on a planetary scale. The Earth would not be strongly disturbed by the impact and would lose only negligible mass. There would be no noticeable tilt in the Earth's axis, and it would not shift our orbit noticeably. On the other hand, the local effects would be much more devastating, depending on where the space rock impacted. The crater left behind by Bennu would measure 2.87 miles in diameter and have a depth of about 3,900 feet. To give that some perspective, the meteor crater in Arizona is just 3,900 feet in diameter and 560 feet deep. At a distance of 3.1 miles away, the debris, or ejecta, would arrive in just 32 seconds after the impact, and everything in this area would be buried under 51.6 feet of impact ejecta. Because of the impact velocity, no fireball would be created, and there would be no vaporization or thermal radiation damage. The impact would trigger an earthquake with a 6.7 magnitude on the Richter scale. In this 3.1 mile radius, shaking would arrive just seconds after the impact. The earthquake damage would be negligible. However, the airburst after the impact would be far more devastating. It would arrive approximately 15.2 seconds after the impact, and the maximum wind velocity would reach an incredible 3,720 miles per hour. and it would cause significant damage. 90% of all trees would be blown down or stripped, and the area would look much like Tunguska. But let's say Bennu impacted on the ocean. A tsunami wave between 92.4 to 185 feet tall would be generated. And at a distance of 31 miles from the impact site, the wave would arrive in just 8.75 minutes after the impact. Life would be much better for those around 300 miles away from the impact, but cities would still see fine dust, and a major seismic event would occur just 1.67 minutes after the impact. The air blast would only be 7 miles per hour, and with a sound intensity of just 63 decibels. Despite the fact that Bennu doesn't threaten the entire human race, it would still be a major natural disaster, the likes of which has never been seen before in modern times. Most of the damage would be concentrated within tens of miles of the impact site. The planet would be largely unaffected except for a giant crater left behind. But there are other dangerous near-Earth objects out there. In fact, there are over 1,400 potentially hazardous asteroids that have been mapped within close proximity of the Earth and the other planets in our solar system. It is basically a shooting gallery out there, and the more rocks we discover, the higher the chances of us being hit. This is where NASA comes in, and what might be seen by many people as an attempt to save the planet from a future impact. Launched on September 8, 2016, OSIRIS-REx was built by Lockheed Martin Space Systems. Its name is an acronym for Origins, Spectral Interpretation, Resource Identification, Security Regolith Explorer. The cost of the spacecraft is $800 million, not including the almost $200 million launch into space. It has been sent to Bennu for a few different reasons. One of those reasons is that it is possible that Bennu could hold information on how life could have taken a foothold on Earth. NASA also hopes to see what kind of resources could be mined from asteroids of this type that fly close to the planet. Another reason is to determine the composition of the asteroid and give scientists an idea of how the asteroid could be destroyed, since there is a chance that it could impact the planet. Because of this, the asteroid is also being studied for its unstable orbit, because it passed much closer to the Earth than was anticipated. In fact, observations showed that the asteroid had deviated from its gravity-ruled orbit by roughly 100 miles. Now, researchers say that the asteroid is being moved or nudged by sunlight, or what is known as the Yarkovsky effect. Yarkovsky was a 19th century Russian engineer who was the first to propose the idea that a small rocky space object would be nudged in its orbit over long periods of time by the slight push created from absorbing sunlight and then re-emit that energy as heat. This has caused the asteroid to become unpredictable in its orbit. The spacecraft arrived at Bennu on December 3, 2018 and successfully went into orbit around the asteroid on December 31, 2018, where it will now continue to map the surface of the asteroid in detail. During this phase of the mission, OSIRIS-REx will study the composition of the asteroid and find a suitable place for the probe to come into contact and collect a sample. OSIRIS-REx aims to collect at least 2 ounces of dust and gravel from Bennu, the first such attempt by the U.S. after a smaller mission to another asteroid by Japan. But OSIRIS isn't going to land on the asteroid. Instead, it will use a 10-foot arm to collect a sample from the surface in 2020. Thrusters will shoot out nitrogen gas to stir up particles which will then be sucked up by the arm. NASA gets just 3 shots at doing this until the nitrogen gas will be depleted and the effort abandoned. But if successful, and once the spacecraft has the sample, a separate container will break away and head back to Earth, where it will parachute down in Utah in the year 2023. From there, it will head to the Johnson Space Center for processing in a dedicated research facility. But since the spacecraft started to orbit the space rock, NASA has revealed some unexpected findings from the first data received, which is offering clues to the origins of the solar system, and possibly even life on Earth. It is possible that a similar rock may have impacted our planet and introduced the hydrated and carbon-rich material needed for life to begin. What OSIRIS found was the presence of abundant hydrated materials and many large boulders. But that's not all. The NASA spacecraft observed the asteroid shooting out plumes of dust, no fewer than 11 times, that surround it in haze. It is something that NASA has never seen before. One of the things that will be studied from the research and composition data collected by OSIRIS-REx is our ability to destroy it if it does become aligned with the orbit of our planet. We have about 150 years or so to figure out how we can deflect it or destroy it. So odds are good that technology would advance by then. However, we do not have that capacity now. There are plans to make a gravity tractor that would possibly nudge the rock off course, or kinetic impactors. But if time is not on humanity's side, there is the nuclear weapon option, which could possibly break up this rubble pile asteroid. Knowing the course of asteroids as they make their periodic swings through our cosmic neighborhood does much more than let us know how long our species has to live before a bit of space ordnance sends us the way of the dinosaurs. It may mean that we will be able to prevent the disaster from happening at all. We hope you enjoyed the video and want to thank you for tuning in. And if you like this, then don't forget to subscribe and turn on notifications so you'll know when we release a new video. Thanks for watching.